How is Matt Ryan so much better this year than he was last year?
Well, I think the first thing you got to just talk about, it's the second year in office. I know that's cliche, but I do think there was a little bit of an adjustment period for Matt Ryan dealing with the Kyle Shanahan offense. You know, really throughout his career, if you really evaluated Matt Ryan, majority of his offensive systems have been, you know, I don't want to say dink and dunk, but just more surgical like that. 5 yards here, 7 yards here, you know, okay, an occasional post down the middle, whatever it may be. But when you get into this Shanahan offense, this is what makes it such a special offense, is he asks a lot of his quarterbacks physically. It's not like, oh, I'm going to give you this easy completion here. He's going to, no, I want to hit them where it hurts. I want to throw a 20-yard curl route down the middle and throw a 20-yard comeback on the outside and then hit a deep crosser going down the middle of the field. So I think there was just getting used to what Kyle wanted. Kyle's offense does a whole lot of stuff on that side of the ball. So when you're not comfortable mentally sometimes, as you know, you can't let your physical skills come out. And he's improved his throwing and his running, like we saw in the NFC Championship game.
Let me ask you about Kyle. He's going to go to San Francisco. That's like everybody knows that's going to happen,
yes,
right?
Yes, right.
Do you like the Lynch hire?
I do like the Lynch hire. Now, I'm biased. I mean, Kyle is one of my best friends in the world, and I played with John Lynch down in Tampa, and I've known him for a long time. But I think at the end of the day, when you just talk about knowing the game of football and knowing what players are supposed to look like on a quality football team, I think John Lynch has got all that. He's a really smart guy. He understands offensive and defensive football. And then I think, you know, he's been around top-tier talent. He was on Super Bowl teams. He knows what a three-technique D-tackle is supposed to look like, and Warren Sapp and a Simeon Rice and those kind of guys. And I think Kyle really just wanted a football guy, not a guy that had a great system set up and scouting and all that, but he wanted a guy that I think he could trust to say, I want these kind of offensive linemen. I want these kind of receivers. And I think John Lynch is, of course, capable of picking out and finding that talent.
Here's one I agree with you. Just even before you came up here, I agree with you. And it's one of those things that's hard for people who aren't, well, you're a football guy, basketball guy. Like, if you haven't, it's one thing to call games. It's another thing to truly be an analyst and be invested in the fabric of the game.
Right.
And I always felt like Lynch was. It's a different kind of broadcast, a different kind of feel. I'm not trying to get you a GM job, but it's the same type of thing where, like, you really evaluate when you're going to watch call a game.
Right.
Like, you want to know what they're going to run on third down.
Yes.
You don't just want to know the personalities and the big storylines. And I feel like it's that level of investment. Probably why he was a great player. He had
exactly.
to make that same level of investment. And that's why it'll work. I actually like that more than somebody who was an assistant GM and understood how somebody else has always done it.
I'm totally with you. And I think it goes to another point where, in the NFL, there's a semi-civil war in the NFL right now between people who are perceived as football people and then guys that are perceived as front office, doesn't really know the game, but understands salary cap and understands.
But you can hire those people.
I mean, you need those guys, but
yes.
I don't want to make in football decisions.
I agree.
And I think you really look at the teams we see always being competitive year in and year out, Seattle, New England, Pittsburgh, those type of teams, they have football guys making the football decisions on players and who to draft and things like that. And I think that's where Kyle went. He just wanted to go with a guy he knew and understood the type of players he wanted.